So, herzlich willkommen auch nochmal von mir.
Schön, hello hier everybody, zu sein. Nice to be here. So late tonight. I heard this is a prime time at 11.
Ich bin David, ich bin Informatiker aus Bonn.
I'm David, computer science specialist from Bonn.
Hier im Kongress war schon mal ein bisschen anfangen. Wenn man hier auf dem Kongress
and
dann,
I'd like to start with what was in the, here in the past in Bonn or when you looked at streams from Congress or when you were here. Then afterwards, there's always some kind of devices that you don't really like to use anymore because, well, yeah, of what you heard in the presentations. Like when you were in Starbucks talk, you don't like to use biometric devices anymore.
Ein besonders inniges Verhältnis hat zu seinem Kopierer.
Like one advice, if somebody has a special relationship with his copy machine, this presentation is not really for you. In this presentation, we'll do three things. We'll look at one of the most common and most dangerous bugs of the last years. And we'll try to make it plausible for techies and non-techies and interesting at the same time. And for activists, we look at how a single person can deal with going against a big company. So I'll talk about how this developed and how which mistakes I made and how it went down. And it's a little bit like a novel, and it starts with a prologue for the conspiracy theorists starting in 2008.
Barack Obama war gegen Hillary Clinton.
In 2008, the primaries in the USA with Obama against Hillary, and there were some anonymous mails that should be useful to Hillary, and it was held that Obama was born in Kenya and thus not fit for being a president because you need to be a natural born citizen, which is not actually like a properly defined. The Americans are not really sure themselves, but yeah, at least in theory, you know, you need to be American born.
Und zweitens, man muss es auch bei seiner Geburt gewesen sein. Also wenn ich jetzt hinkomme, frisch eingebürgert,
das common knowledge is you need to be American and you need to have to be American at birth. So that Barack Obama's second name is Hussein is also not that optimal in that context. So then he published his short birth certificate that's published behind the speaker.
Wer ein guter Verschwörungstheoretiker ist, der lässt sich aber von Fakten nicht ablenken.
Like if you're a good conspiracy theorist, you're not gonna be dispelled by facts.
Sofort kamen Anschuldigungen, die Geburtsurkunde wäre gefälscht.
Like immediately there were claims that the birth certificate was false, like a stamp was not on the right place and stuff like that.
Aufkleber von so ein paar Obama-Gegnern. Der unterste Aufkleber verlangt explizit die Geburtsurkunde.
Like now you see some license plate stickers or car stickers claiming that your Obama wasn't fit to be president. This is like the birther movement, and they want to prove that Obama is not a real American, and yeah.
So 2.5 years
later, when Obama was already president, he published the long form of his birth certificate, shown right in the picture. So you could think now it would be quiet, but again there were claims that the birth certificate would be false. And let's look at it a bit more in detail. Like the left is a picture is a strong magnification of the right image.
Und uniform durchgefärbt.
And you can see that between the different letters, between the one and the four, there's various differences in gradient and sharpness. And how is that that there's such a difference between one in one and the same line?
Gegen normale, leicht unscharfe und verrauschte Ziffern und Ankreuzkästchen.
So in this additional example, you also see that between the two boxes that there's a very strict hard difference between the boxes and the rest of the text.
Oder hier besonders schön, ja? Dieser Bildausschnitt ist unten aus dem Stempel. Man sieht einen Druckfehler im Stempel.
So this part of the image is taken from the stamp, and so it looks like there was a printing error in the stamp, but you know that's very unlikely.
And
so maybe you know even you could say maybe the intern in the White House was too stupid to use Photoshop. So PR disaster, of course. For Obama, there was a census poll that actually showed that at least 5% believed that Obama wasn't born in the USA, and at least 8 more percent that he probably wasn't born in the USA. So, and even today, they still get requests for comments.
Okay, now we jump to 2013. And the 24th of July 2013, a company called me, and they have two big Xerox work centers. Xerox work centers, those are huge business copying machines that every company has. They have network, they can scan, print, and fax and mail and print and everything, and they cost as much as a little car. And that's not your grandmother's printer, but they have hundreds of users per machine. And here you can see a blueprint, and the black spaces are not original. I blotted them out because I couldn't have used this blueprint otherwise. But there are three yellow places, and these yellow places are standardized blocks which show the area of room in square meters. And we talk about those now. And the company said, "Hey, David, if we scan the blueprint, there are different scans after, there are different numbers after we've scanned them. Can you take a look at that?" And on the left side, that's me.
Also man muss dazu sagen, die Stimmung mit denen
we have to say that's always a good atmosphere with them, and my parents helped me, and this company did IT service for the company, and they were very friendly, and I thought they were pulling my leg. That's sure, right? Yeah, a copier changing numbers. Sure, you hear that every day, of course. Yeah, and they said, "Oh no, really? Look at it. We need this machine. It has to work properly." Okay, so I went there and took a look, and still thinking, that's just a prank for me. And they have a Xerox Work Center 7535, and here are the three original things before the scan, so I can read that. And at the top is 14.13, and then there's 21.11 square meters, and on the lower one there's 17 point something square meters. So put the blueprint into the work center and scanned it. And here are the same places after the scan. And so apparently that's quite funny, right? So all the rooms are now 14.13 square meters. No, that's impossible. This isn't happening there. But I still thought this was a prank. And so just to, I've been asked this a lot of times, and there was no OCR. This is really, the replacement of the numbers happens on the pixel level. And the company has another work center, the 7570. And so and there are many, many more like this. And it's a big family of machines. And on the small one, there were always the same numbers that came out. On the big one, every time there were different numbers. And yeah, well, so it's bigger, so there's more CPU power. And so look at those numbers. There's number 2 on the middle line there. We have 14.13, and in the middle we have 21.11. So that would have been the correct value. So sometimes it's right. And similar in the other lines. So one of you needs an NSA random number generator. So here's one.
Beachtet außerdem, ne, das ist nämlich eigentlich
also look at well it's not very funny, but I'm laughing too. So also look that the numbers look absolutely perfect in the layout, and they only noticed it because a room that's obviously bigger has a smaller area than the smaller one. So there's a big ballroom with 4 square meters and a little chamber by the side that is much bigger. I know that the font is very small, but so it's not a very, very strange fringe case, so that I could piss on them. But we have some more examples. But this is the original example where we found it. But here's the next example. This is a register, the cost register, and so you see the 2 sixes turned into 8s, and the joke is really that the picture is look here, 6 turned into an 8. So and someone said, oh, there's another one. Oh. So this was just looks absolutely clean. It looks perfect. And so why did they notice the error here? Because the numbers were sorted in ascending order. So you can't see it really. If the numbers have no sense, and you cannot see which ones are wrong. So it's always, you have to have semantic criteria where you can find out what happens, something so that it becomes implausible. Otherwise, you don't have a chance to find out what it is. So my neck gets longer and longer, as you can see. So these are not just random things. So I tried reproducing it like a good computer scientist. So I made columns of numbers in ascending order in different sizes and different fonts and scanned them and did some experiments. And lo and behold, I could reproduce the error. So these are my random numbers, and we will look at them again in the future. So the ones that are yellow should be 6s and should not be the 8s that we can see there. So we stop for a moment here, and I promised that I'm going to show you the entire interaction with Xerox, and I tell you what I felt at every time, and I stress those things that are very important if you have to fight against the big company, and I will also show you proof about this. But I will tell you one thing up front. In my eyes, what does not help is becoming offensive and hating. And that is not helpful. That's very nice that you applaud now, but I wasn't so sure. And I have no problem with Twitter, but if you want to do something, if you want to achieve something, you make yourself a target, and nobody's going to take you seriously. And they will tell you that you don't want to have a discussion because that wouldn't fit in 140 characters.
Und zweitens kann man euch immer vorwerfen, nur Aufmerksamkeit.
And secondly, you can always say that you only want the show. If I don't want you to do these things, what should you do? The best things to do is to not make it publicly initially. So you could write mails or call them. So I called Xerox support several times, very often. I called all support levels up to top level in Dublin, and nobody knew a single thing. We wanted personal contact as well. Xerox people who were at the site at the time, they didn't know anything either. They're not Xerox people, they're just working commission.
Xerox was shocked. They tried to reproduce it, and they did.
Also das war, wir lachen hier jetzt, ne?
We're laughing about this, but they were standing there with their pants down. And, you know, imagine somebody's coming along and questioning your very existence. So Xerox itself, not a support company, but Xerox, the company, they were astonished. But they didn't try to help us or the support firm. They respected the problem, but well.
Also es gab überhaupt aber gar keine Anzeichen für größeres Interesse.
But there weren't any signs of bigger interest or any advice how we could get rid of the problem. So somebody came from Xerox Center and updated our software and, you know, he gave us new firmware. So I was like, oh great, now we know that the problem existed 3 years ago as well. After there hadn't been a sign of progress on the side of Xerox after a week, I thought, right, that's enough. So I wrote a blog post in German and English about what I just told you now, and I offered some test documents people could download to print, scan, and see if they were affected as well. That's how the story starts to spread. I have to say, my blog isn't huge, not at all. So 500 to 1,000 readers per day, that's not a lot, it's not nothing either, but most of them are IT geeks, that's what I know from the emails people send me.
Seht ihr ab jetzt eine Linie? Diese Linie
on the bottom of my slides, you can now see a line. It's a plot of the page views. It's going to get wider and wider as I continue to speak. It's a sign of showing how much attention I'm getting. Can you see it? Yes, you can. Good. The small bump there. That's a small peak of 3,000 hits per hour. The numbers come from Google Analytics. I've been told you're supposed to take to multiply them by two, but never mind, you get the idea. On 2nd and 3rd of August, the story spread on some tech blogs. Is Felix von Neitner in the room?
No.
I've been told that many people read FIFA. Anyway, the people you see is from FIFA's blog. So the story spreads and I get more and more emails from people who are affected. But the funny thing is I also get loads and loads of confirmation for Xerox work centers I'd never heard of. And, you know, it's a whole product family, so I'm starting to think that this might be a huge story. Lesson learned, it was good of me to provide the documents right away and online. If people hadn't been able to reproduce it for themselves, it wouldn't have spread as much. 4th of August, the story spreads worldwide in tech portals. This is Hacker News, you probably know it. And I'm starting to get hundreds of emails per day from technical from people who, you know, from tech-savvy people. And throughout the time, I'm trying to channel and sort the emails I'm getting. And only that allowed me to continue the story and to solve the bug professionally.
Dass US-Reportern bewusst ist, dass es jemals sowas wie Zeitzonen.
And I'm not allowed to sleep anymore either because I'm starting to get loads of emails from US reporters who apparently don't know about time zones. That's another small anecdote. You'd think they compete with each other, but but as soon as one of them had my phone number, all of them had it. So, lesson learned. Write it in multiple language. Important, of course, is English for the international countries, but also the language of whatever company you're targeting. And you may know that Xerox is so widespread in the US that there's actually a verb for it. It's to Xerox.
So, und wenn in der Technikwelt was so die Runde macht, was kommt als nächstes?
And whenever something is that big in the tech world, what comes next? Mass media.
Ab da hat man das volle Programm.
And that's where it starts to get huge. I'll click through it. It's not an exhaustive list at all. There were hundreds of articles worldwide suddenly. And I'm just doing it in random order, however it suits my my talk. This is Heise. As an IT guy, I like this a lot.
ZDF Hyperland.
ZDF Hyperland.
Die deutsche Presse mehr zur Ansicht. Die deutsche Presse war nämlich eher zurückhaltend. Die meisten
eigentlich. I'm mainly showing the German press just to illustrate it. Most of it was actually from the US.
Ein Journalist hat mir erzählt.
But as a side note, a journalist told me he wanted to bring it to Tagesschau, the biggest German news journal.
Und wichtigen Kopien passiert und nicht nur beim Scannen.
He was, it's really cool, but we wanted to show it happens when you photocopy things, not just when scanning, because people don't scan.
Also falls jetzt jemand von der Tagesschau zusieht,
so if someone from the Tagesschau is in the audience, that applause was yours.
Ich dachte mir nur, ihr Helden, ja, Profi-Tipp, wenn man so einen Scan ausdruckt, ne, dann hat man eine Kopie, ne? Mit dem Unterschied, dass so ein gespeicherter Scan einfach.
I was like, you heroes, like. If you print a scan, you have a photocopy. Never mind.
Das geht gerade ohnehin weltweit durch einen Kanal. Das ist ja nicht mein Problem, wenn genau ihr das jetzt als Einzige nicht bringt. Lesson learned. Professionell und souverän bleiben. Ja? Nicht einfach Sachen aus Aufmerksamkeitsgier aufbauschen.
So don't just make it bigger than it is just to just because you want the attention.
Blut geleckt und was
ausgedacht. Yeah, you... smell some blood and then you wanted to make it bigger. It's not cool. So Economist, now it gets really serious and now it's getting expensive for the companies. As ABC News. More expensive, BBC, CNBC, then it was everywhere. That's Business Week. It's a popular business magazine. Until now, there was no reaction from Xerox.
So, and when man so langsam reagiert,
if you react that slow, it's getting very uncomfortable. On the scale of things too horrible to contemplate, document altering scanner is right up there with flesh eating bacteria. That's from Peter Coy, Economist Editor for Business Week.
Das schreiben die O-Tonen in der Business Week.
That's like original citation from Business Week.
Da bin ich vom Kumpel angerufen worden. Hör mal, du musst dir das durchlesen. Also super Sache. Ich stelle euch vor, das ist Peter Coy. Der ist
Peter Coy. He's editor there and we'll.
So, mein Blogartikel ist jetzt so.
We get to him a few more times in this presentation. Now my blog post went up to like 300,000 readers a day and still no reaction from Xerox. Like in the meantime, I managed with some readers to show what actually happened, and now I'm going to tell you about that and a little bit about picture compression.
Sowohl die Fliege als auch der Text gehören
zum Test. The test build that I did, it's a fly with some text, and they both are part of the text of the test picture. For to have different kinds of test pictures. Data transmission is time, money, and storage intensive, and costs a lot of data. So you normally don't want to transfer them uncompressed. Everywhere pictures are transferred, and even in the highest offices, like. A while ago, there was some a lot of media attention to a German MDP that had tried to transmit pictures, and of course he doesn't want to get crappy pictures. And doesn't want to wait too long.
Jetzt haben wir zwei Ausschnitte meines Testbildes, einen vom Fototeil und einen vom Textteil.
parts of the test image, one of the picture and one from the text. They're very much enlarged, so we can look at what goes wrong at different with different compression algorithms. There are lossless compression methods, so no information is lost, or if you want to get it even smaller, we have lossless codecs that to get the files even smaller. This is a popular GIF format. Verlustbehaftet ist.
Wow, das sind viele. Das sind fast alle. GIF ist eine verlustfreie.
So that was the show of hands for who
der
shows GIF is loss, lossy,
also nicht davon,
but actually GIF is a lossless compression, but it only supports 256 colors, so the loss of information is because of the picture reduction. And that's then saved pixel by pixel with all that W, which is an old compression algorithm, kind of like the... So it's good. GIF is good for graphics with a few colors. Sharp edges are preserve well, less well is it, it's less suited for photos. Now we have JPEG. JPEG isn't saved, JPEG is lossy, and then the original picture is put into 8x8 pixel blocks and like processed with cosinus waves. How exactly this is mathematically done, I won't bother you with, but, well, you can read up on it if you want. So this is really good for photo images, but very bad for text. You can see that if you look at the it's a text on the right.
Genau darum gibt es das JBIC 2.
So different compression algorithms are good for different kind of uses. So that's why you have JBIC 2.
In viele Unterbilder zerlegen.
Compression algorithm in which you can separate parts of the image into various patches and that then can can use different compression algorithms for each of these patches, which you can see at the red boxes. So you can use GIF for the text patches and then
und den Foto patch zum Beispiel mit JPEG.
And the photo patch you can use JPEG for example. And maybe you wouldn't use exactly those, but kind of like this.
Wenn man weiß, welcher Patch was enthält, einen sauberen Qualitätseindruck erhält und wahrscheinlich eine kleinere Datei.
So obviously, if you know exactly what kind of content is in which patch, you get a much better result in total.
Man kann das Ursprungsbild noch viel feiner zerlegen und jeden
so obviously, if that works, then you can do it much more advanced. So that in for text, you do a separate patch for every letter, and this is actually also done. That's not I didn't make this up. And then, yeah, you are gonna look at which patches are very similar to each other. Like the patches I marked there, that's all small e's, and you know they only have very few pixels that are different. So you get groups of all the difference of all the similar patches, and so you just use the same patch all over again in the same image. So only one of them is actually saved and used for all others. So you can actually save a lot of data, and that's the final result, still looks good, uses much less data than without pattern matching. Did you see it? Pattern matching thinks that the small I is similar to the L. That's what happens when pattern matching is not exactly accurate. And now, did you see that as well?
Sowas sind saugefährliche Fehler.
That's very dangerous mistakes.
Normale Kompressionsfehler wären ja nicht schlimm. Da ist
normal compression artifacts are not that that problematic. Like maybe you can't read it that well, but it's still okay. But now you have perfectly looking data letters that still look great, and you really have to read it to notice the errors. And even then, you don't even notice them. And of course, most people don't really always check their scans afterwards.
Also, liebe Leute, ein Politiker, der diese Sache schönreden muss, ja, der würde sagen,
so a politician who has to make this put this in positive light, you could say that if you do a cost scan of a medicine sheet in a retirement home and in one go help the retirement benefits. People from Berlin. How were the plans for yet unfinished Berlin Airport actually copied?
Aber wisst ihr was? Flughafen, Medikamente, Raketen,
Airports, Medicine. Airplanes, rockets, it's only like small fish, but if this actually was used as evidence in a case in court, that's really interesting. So now if somebody sues me with a scan from Xerox, I would just say, you know, that's false. And you can't even prove anymore that like part of the scan actually comes from the original where you would expect it to be. It's business appliances, they have hundreds of thousands of users, and I was called by a big business, and like every incoming mail is just scanned automatically and from there on only used electronically.
Wir befinden uns 3 Tage nach dem Ersteinschlag und am dritten Tag schuf Gott endlich.
Now the 5th of August, 3 days after the first impact, and then God created a life sign from Xerox.
Dankeschön.
And thank you. And the PR of Xerox Germany calls me, and they can't really do anything without the American, and they thought it was just a prank, and I said, no, it's not a joke. And they say, well, we keep in contact. And the day after that, the 6th of August, was the first one where really things started going. And in the morning, I got the screenshot from a user from the setup, and there it talks about letter replacement. And okay, so there are 3 PDF compression states. They are normal, high, and high. So it's like PR compatible. Normal is the mode that compresses the strongest. And the reader says normal, the error is there, and in the 2 other stages, it's not. And as far as I could see at that point in time, that was correct. But I'll tell you more about that later.
Ich habe ja versprochen, euch die Stimmung über diese
Fälle aufzulegen, falls ihr selbst in so einer Situation seid. How I feel doing that, and at first I was afraid, I was really, and I thought I was being portrayed as the idiot who hadn't read the manual, but now there is no official statement from Xerox, but I was tipped off that Xerox was about to write something like that. So the lesson learned is the internal view and the outside view is so. What's the problem? What's the problem now? Such a problem must never happen. Not even if you know about it. But the inside view is quite interesting. But even if you're freaked out, just keep calm and never scream and always de-escalate and never become offensive. And if you remain calm from the beginning, and then you can really talk about them, and you can just ask, why didn't support tell me that 2 weeks ago. So remain professional and never hate, and I'll tell you again.
So, also Vorwärtsverteidigung. So, ich den Screenshot als
okay, I showed the screenshot as a possible workaround, and I recommended to set the compression to high. And I was curious why support couldn't tell me that. And I also criticized that that setup was called normal, and the consequences, well, and the problem remains because you can't see in the scan that it is wrong. And so I wanted to be prepared against what Xerox was going to do. And so this is Rick Dustin, and he is the vice president of Xerox, and Francis Tse is one of the chief engineers. And here the boss is doing the support, so that's really something.
Rick Dustin is in der Tat.
Rick Dustin is the first one to my talk to who really actually works at Xerox and who confirmed that it was known at Xerox that it replaced characters. So if you have a problem with support and talk to them for a week and they can't tell you anything, then ask them to talk to Rick Dustin. And so they also confirmed that it was correct that the pattern matching is responsible, and he also confirmed that pattern matching was only done in normal mode. So support screwed up, and normal was probably a silly name for the setting, so I recommended experimental.
So.
Okay, so perhaps now I'm feeling quite good, and it's a lot of fun, but at that time I was really scared. And don't think I'm any different than you. And then there was a very crystal clear RTFM by Xerox. Well, but the normal mode isn't a factory default, so you are all stupid. Why do you set it to a different setting? And the manual also says that letter replacement may occur, so you are doubly stupid. Customers are doubly stupid. And for the customer, of course, factory setting is the setup in which they get the machine, and they don't get it from Xerox themselves, but there are third-party companies from which you buy those companies, and you don't buy it from Xerox, and they do consulting for you. And the manual, in some manuals, actually, there is on page 107 on 328. Okay, well, how many people read manuals that are 300 pages thick before using a copier? I mean, really. So, and I also found that copiers are not designed in a way that I'm of the opinion that this should never happen in a copying machine, in whatever setting. And the answer is, of course, oh, yes, that may happen. That's what they say. And the market wants that, and the market demands that, and the errors.
And
that was really, really what they said. I'm quoting, and well, they said that about the small documents, and the errors were very, very rare, but I was right, and you couldn't prove that a document was wrong. And so there was a relaxed atmosphere, and they didn't threaten me legally, and they listened to me, and it was a long talk, and I really let myself be caught in a trap, and I never did anything of that scale. And Xerox, of course, they are professionals. And I was wondering why we could talk that long in a relaxed atmosphere. So Rick Dustin is a vice president of a huge global company, and he probably had other things to do. So, and now it turned out that during I was on the phone with them, they released their press statement. They're really not stupid, because that's the time in which I cannot react. And the press release had the title, Always Listening to Our Customers. And they say, who wants to have original data and use the compression setting of higher or higher? And the lesson learned was, and always have someone else watch the website of your adversary. And I talked an article about the telephone conference, and I also wrote that I don't think they're off the hook. So, well, that was the end, right? No, if a single blogger fights a huge company, the blogger caves in when the company shoots back, or the public sides with the big company, or the public loses interest.
Ist alles nicht passiert.
So nothing of that happened. And you can see the huge spike. The head was on the title page of Slashdot. And the press was on my side. And so here's Heise said that I was talking about the workaround before Xerox did.
Ich werde ein bisschen überziehen.
So to set it too high.
And
also, Der Spiegel also said, so Xerox knew about the problem. Aha. So well, that's really nice. If you're sitting in the PR, and if something like that happens, and you work for the PR of a company, you can screw your holidays for the rest of the year. So, but now really gets funny. If you have ever been in the US, they say, when the shit hits the fan. That's what you say if it really starts getting ugly.
And
next day it was on Reddit on the title page. There was the nicest version of shit hits the fan that I've ever seen. I think it says if the fecal matter hits the rotating air propeller, something. Right. So, well, it's true. And if a company is specializing in or relies on digitization of documents, and almost everyone is, then they all have a problem. They can close the shop if it's really bad. And the National Archive called me, and they made their entire archive with Xerox machines, and they threw away the originals. So, and now they are looking at they look at the big archive and think that they have to look at all the documents and check them for plausibility. And in other cases, the internet is also very, very nice. You had one job, Xerox, eight job.
Manchmal sorgen die Beteiligten für den Humor auch
sometimes
selbst.
They are really funny. The company themselves create a joke. And this is something I'll just read it for you. And that's for the BBC. And Dustin said, well, it's not really that bad. The normal compression mode can create errors, but nobody uses it except the military or oil platforms. What can happen? What's the worst that can happen, right?
Jetzt haben wir alle mitbekommen, dass viele auf Ölbohrinseln in den USA in letzter Zeit ein bisschen
problems on oil platforms are not really looked upon very kindly in the US now. So and I really tell you, laughing is nice, but just imagine you're in Dustin's shoes, and if you really have to talk about that on the phone for 14 hours, then really something may slip, and you may let slip something, and maybe he has been quoted out of context, and he may be right. I've no reason not to believe him. And here's a tech portal that is happy that cat pictures are not affected.
And
but maybe it's about cat pictures, so who knows. But there's a new press release from Xerox. There was big public pressure, and now, maybe yes, perhaps we are going to make a patch in which we don't do pattern matching. But they never admitted to a mistake or to a problem. But so it's the same thing always. They always have to cover their ass. So telling in the manual for microwaves not to put the cat inside. So, but if they wait that long, then not even announcing a patch doesn't save you. Even the press releases now have sometimes errors in it. But now, and it says now, you will not see replacement of characters if you set the compression to higher and at least 200 dpi. And they also said that pattern matching is only done in the normal compression mode and not in the higher modes. And I always thought, I was quite sure that I had seen the problem in higher modes. Another reader told me as much, and I didn't manage to do it in my own devices that I had access to. But if it does that in other modes, then everyone would be affected, and Xerox had been lying, and we had a huge, a much bigger global problem. So I'm just not putting out any rumor, but a friend of mine in Bonn, where I was living at the time, he took his work center of another number, which I said 7545, and it was where I lived. So we went there and we used my test numbers, and we used the mode higher, and even 300 dpi for 300 dpi for text. That is quite. And now look at this, the yellow numbers. The yellow numbers have errors, and I just marked some of them. I don't look good at all of them, but so you can see how frequent this problem is, and there was in mode higher and with 300 dpi.
Rot markiert, oder sieht man jetzt nur so ganz bisschen rosa, aber man sieht's.
Die Pixel, you can't quite make it out, but the pixels are exactly the same, these red rectangles, and that's very unlikely. It's always going to look a bit different if you scan it naturally. And lots of digits that look exactly the same pixel by pixel. That's a clear sign of pixel, not pattern matching. So contrary to what Xerox was saying, they really were performing pattern matching even here. And
one of my readers built a visualization that marks equal digits in red. All equal digits are marked when I hover them with the mouse. Here you can see how many digits could possibly be wrong. At this point I knew there are hundreds of thousands of devices affected in factory defaults. With something like that you can really damage a big company. I did not want to publish that without trying to talk to them in before. Also, I wanted to make sure that I did not make any mistake and could be sued on billions of loss in shareholder value.
So I recorded the whole process of producing wrong digits on video and uploaded it non-public on YouTube. I sent the link to Francis, the principal engineer, and they were shocked. Francis told me on the phone that I did everything correctly.
Xerox was cooperative, but they wanted me to wait until they could reproduce the error by themselves. I remember that I felt a little bit fooled after the last conference call and told them, this time we do this differently.
I told them, yeah, I've already written my blog article and the video is done, and don't take this the wrong way, but I want to be contacted all the time now. So a lot of phoning back and forth ensues. We call ourselves all the time. I'd really spend the night in the office, and I only had stupid biscuits. And finally Francis calls me and tells me, yep, we've produced it. Pattern matching on factory defaults, everyone was shocked. And do you know what they found out later? The code for the compression kernel is 8 years old. That's how long this bug has been in the wild. And they've been a bit surprised. So I told them, here, have a look at my article and make sure that I've got legal safety, and I can push it out. That mistake is really dangerous, and I don't want to wait much longer.
And
they did it, and they allowed me to publish it before them too. So verhandle im richtigen That's Moment. Why you shouldn't hate on them. Lesson learned.
Das hier ist das nächste Xerox Pressestatement. Ich ziehe ein bisschen
negotiate at the right moment.
Xerox hat sich direkt im
Xerox, right afterwards, brought their own statement. They retracted their previous communication and thanked me and actually notice how big this whole thing is. And that's why they started to be really nice in their press statements and the whole climate was entirely constructive. And the whole thing becomes more and more surreal.
Und hier ist wieder unser bissiger Peter Coy von der Business.
Here again is Peter Coy from Business Week. Oh, I've got one more for you.
Also einen Kompressionsmodus.
One compression mode.
Ist jetzt ja eigentlich egal, aber am 11. August.
Never mind now, but on the 11th of August, I can actually prove that it happens in highest mode as well. So even people
are
creating massively beautiful PDFs for ages. Couldn't escape this issue. But to be honest, it doesn't happen with TIFFs. On the 12th of August, Xerox admits that it's a bug that's 8 years old and announces the patch another time. And, you know, they're really affected on the legal side. And so, in the middle of the night, my time, Dustin and C called me on my mobile to be the first to tell me that they'd found the bug and they'd be rolling out new software to all devices. That's a patch download page from Xerox. That shows you how many devices are affected by this. And look at the X's, those are families.
So, die Presse berichtet wieder,
so the press reports again, the computer magazine CT has a report and calls it Scannergate. And here, there's a final clip from Peter Coy. It may sound sarcastic, but he is completely right. Eight yearly productions of archived scanned documents can contain these errors and damage things forever. We live in a society that right now, as we speak, is doing its transition from paper to digital. And the translators between the two words are devices like Xerox work centers. And the most important thing, I told you Xerox has a... sells its devices through third parties, and that's why I think patches haven't reached too many devices at all. So spread the word.
So, es neigt sich dem Ende. Neben den ganzen Lessons learned, gibt es eine Lesson, die ich bis jetzt noch nicht gesagt habe?
Beside all the lessons learned, there's one lesson I haven't told you yet. I've always gathered incredulous looks when I told people that I hadn't earned a single cent from this. A manager even told me I was an idiot. Two things. Firstly, it's really hard to earn money with this. If you can't prove it, people are not going to take you seriously. And secondly, corporations don't know friends. If I had wanted money, they would have shot me down for it.
Ich würde es wieder so machen, aber
I would do it again like this, but at the end of the day, everybody has to decide for themselves. If you want to do it differently, that's fine. I just want to tell you, you weaken your negotiation position. These are all the lessons learned. I'm not going to go through them again, but if you download the slides, here they are. And this is how the circle closes to the introduction. That was a prologue with Barack Obama's birth certificate. Here it is again. Shortly afterwards, journalists from Reality Check in the US asked me if the Xerox bug might not be the cause for these. And they'd done detective work already, so for instance, the Obamas had published their tax work. It had been scanned with a Xerox Work Center 7655.
So,
they asked me if I could ask Xerox because I had connections, and understandably Xerox said, no, we've really got different things on our minds right now. And Now I look back at the PDF and look, will you have a look at this? They contain exactly the same characters that had caused the bug in the first place. Here are two boxes that look exactly the same. I mean, make up your own mind, but I think this shoots down the conspiracy theory. And all I have to say now is thank you for spending this hour with me.
So.
This concludes Never Trust a Scam That You Didn't Forge Yourself. Thank you very much for listening in. If you have feedback to the translators, tweet at C3Translate or use the hashtag C3T. For more information, consult the wiki page translation. This is Philipp Bock, Bernd and Florian from the translators booth. Thanks again and goodbye.
Mit den Fragen würde ich zunächst mit denen aus dem Internet anfangen, von unserem Signal Angel.
Vielen Dank. Auch ein riesen Applaus aus dem Internet, das konntest du jetzt nicht hören, aber es war sehr viel positives Feedback da. Auch die Bitte, die Folien zu veröffentlichen, insbesondere die Symbolbilder, kamen sehr gut an.
Das wird passieren auf meiner Seite spätestens morgen.
Definitiv. Sehr schön, vielen Dank. Zwei Fragen habe ich. Die erste Frage ist, gibt es bei Xerox technischen Unterschied zwischen Scannen und Drucken und Kopieren? Oder ist das intern immer das Gleiche?
Ja, also Scannen, da geht das Papier rein, beim Drucken kommt es raus. Ne? Also beim Drucken werden einfach Druckdaten entgegengenommen. Da ist mir nicht bekannt, dass überhaupt nochmal irgendwas nachkomprimiert wird. Scannen, da gibt es verschiedene Modi. Die PDF-Modi, das sind die drei, wovon ich gesprochen habe. Und Kopieren, meiner Ansicht nach ist es nicht so, dass es genau nach dem Kopieren, dass es beim Kopieren auch passiert, weil da nicht komprimiert wird, so wie ich das sehe. Ja? Also ich bin mir sicher, ich hätte Berichte bekommen, wäre dem so. Also deswegen denke ich nicht, dass der Kopiervorgang an sich betroffen ist, aber das ist auch nicht so krass schlimm, denn da werden auch keine Dokumente archiviert.
Okay, und die zweite Frage, gibt es irgendwelche handfesten Schädigungen, die aufgrund dieses Bugs passiert sind? Hast du da irgendwelche Rückmeldungen bekommen?
Ich habe Rückmeldungen, die ich gerade gesagt habe und natürlich noch ein paar andere und bin natürlich angehalten, hier keine Namen zu nennen. Aber ihr müsst euch mal in die, also ich will nur so viel sagen, ihr müsst euch in die Lage vom Konzern versetzen, der da betroffen ist. Eure Daten sind also vielleicht im Arsch. So, werdet ihr das öffentlich machen? Nein, ihr werdet in aller Stille von Xerox Schadenersatz verlangen und möglichst nichts davon auf eure eigene Webseite schreiben, weil das nämlich auf euch zurückfällt, dass eure Daten kaputt sind. Da fragt doch keiner danach, ob das jetzt ein Xerox-Kopierer war. Also ich erwarte auch nicht, dass es da größere Enthüllungen gibt, sofern sie nicht vermeidbar sind. Wenn da jetzt irgendwie eine Autobahnbrücke zusammenbricht, ist natürlich was anderes.
Okay, vielen Dank nochmal.
Gerne.
Gut, dann würde ich vorschlagen, wir machen bei Mikrofon 2 bei der ersten Person weiter.
Ja, nur eine kurze Frage. Das ist ja eine Technik, die wahrscheinlich von vielen eingesetzt wird. Habt ihr das mit Großgeräten anderer Hersteller schon mal ausprobiert?
Ich hatte eine Latte von Meldungen über andere Hersteller. Aber wenn man eine Sache dieser Größenordnung macht, wird man sofort Opfer von Spin-Doctoring.
We just realized there were question and answers. Sorry about that. We didn't realize because everybody left. But just don't publish any rumors, and because you make yourself a target. And in the end, it just could have been something else, and always
publish proof.
Thank you. That was very nice, and I'm surprised that the bug has been was 8 years old. And do you have you looked in search engines? I mean, I really can't imagine that for 8 years nobody has seen this. And or did people tell you who had seen that earlier, or I've seen that years ago and at higher compressions? One thing is that it's very hard to detect, and it was known for the normal mode. And it was they knew that it happened, and so it was hard to find the real bug, because Xerox support people who knew it just said, oh, don't set it to normal. So a normal that happens, set it to another level that is rarer. Maybe you're lucky.
But
I think it was really the first time the bug was found. It was, but nobody contacted me and said, I've seen this already.
And
so from number two, hi, and thank you very much for the talk. Short question, you didn't do it for money, but and I find that great, but and did they offer you anything? No, no, never. No, they didn't. And I really Xerox was really, really good there and handled it very, very well. And there was really, in the long night where we phoned and they really were about to fly me in, and I really can't fix anything like that. But if they had been flying, I've been flying you in, and you could cooperate to fix the bug, but really I can't contribute anything. They in their own code they have to find the bug themselves, and I can't really help there. I was just sitting around there. Yeah, it should make sense. Yeah, and two intercontinental trips for that, it's really not. If they would pay for that, well, yeah, and I really thought about if they would have paid, but. Just didn't fit in my schedule, so I couldn't do it. Okay, number three. Okay. All right, I have a home copier at home, and I have a very close relationship with it. And have there been any reports that it happened on home copiers? But no, I don't know anything about that. It was only these work centers, the series that I just showed, the work center, and it's just the big business machines, really. So as far as I know, this JBeg 2 compression algorithms is quite expensive to implement. And number three again, please.
There was a
cool crowd research task is perhaps to look through these manuals and collect them, whoever can get them, and look at in which year it appears in the documentation. Is that as old as the bug, or so 8 years, or did it only happen in after 4 years, 4 years ago, or maybe they thought it would just print new manuals because it's cheaper, and we leave the software as that, and we there are suspicions that they called a bug feature, and so I mean, whoever would design a copier that changes numbers, even if only the military uses it. Okay, one last question. It's not really a question, but maybe a suggestion for the talk. It was really great talk, thank you. And you have this scale there with the access history. Can you perhaps do that? Superimpose the stock of the Xerox stock price, but Xerox managed that pretty well. There was such a problem that it could really be the end of the company, but that didn't happen. So maybe we should really put the live stock exchange rates here. But this is a nice thing. We have a question from the internet. Yes, from the internet. Are there any statistics or numbers about the probability of the error? But you've seen the page, and it was just the thing with font size 7 or 8. And it was only numbers, but that happens also with similar letters, but I have no statistics about that. And the numbers are 6 and 8, the highest probability, but I really have no hard data for the probabilities, and I didn't have to try around for hours. I just scanned one page, and it was like that. So it's really, you don't have to search for it for very long.
Okay.
Thank you.
Wären wir, glaube ich, soweit.
So then we are
dann
done.
Um einen Applaus für unseren Vortragenden.
And another round of applause, please, for the talk.